Hello guys and welcome back for a brand new review. If you are new to the channel, please make sure you're gonna subscribe. You can also leave some comments in the comment section down below. And of course, don't forget to press the like button if you've enjoyed this content. In today's video, we're gonna have a look at a pair of Nike shoes, which they are actually a bit improved for the cold and wet seasons, which they are already here. Let's go ahead and take them out of the box, guys. As you can see, this time we don't have your usual brown or orange color for the box. We're gonna have this gray and black, and we're gonna have a lot of writings here on the top. We're gonna have this big swoosh, the sizing tag on the side. So let's go ahead and take them out, guys. Okay guys, so in today's video we're gonna have a look at this Nike Air Zoom Pegasus 38 Shield. So this new version, guys, of this Pegasus 38, which we already know that it's a very good shoe at a very affordable price, was released here in the UK the second half of October for a retail price of £115, which is actually the same price as the normal Pegasus. But as you can see, this time we're gonna have some differences for the upper. It's gonna be completely changed comparing with the normal Pegasus, but the midsole is gonna be completely the same. So this Pegasus 38 shield, guys, it's actually a weatherized road running shoe with some new materials, which they are supposed to protect us from the rainy days. So this one, it's available now on the Nike website in the two color combinations. So this will be one of them. The second one, you can see it here in the corner. So let's go ahead and do a breakdown of this shoe, guys. So as you can see, starting here at the front of the shoe, we're gonna have this rubberized overlays, which will actually go also to the midfoot. As you can see, we're gonna have this cage, if I can say so, on both sides, which also has a very interesting pattern, as you can see, on both sides. And of course, this rubberized material will also go towards the back of the heel section. So this one for sure will keep some water from coming in. Then as we go towards the lacing system, we're gonna have this material, which is actually an insulated one, which it's PFC free treated. I'm not entirely sure what that is. Nike is not giving us more details, but make sure you follow this video, as we're gonna do a water test towards the end of the video. Going to the lacing system, guys, you can see that we still have some rubberized material here, where this material changes to the different one used for the tongue. So we're gonna have a lot of rubberized overlays to make sure that water will not go through. So the actual lacing system will be this rubberized material, which acts also as a cage. For the laces, we're gonna have this black and gray ones, and just underneath these laces we're gonna have this insulated tongue, which is actually less padded than the normal version, but I didn't find that to be a problem. Also on top of this tongue, we're gonna have this a long tag, which has written on it Nike Shield. And as we get at the ankle section, guys, you can see that we still have this rubberized material, which will cover your heel section. And we're gonna have the Nike swoosh in a bigger and smaller one here on the lateral side, and also we're gonna have the same on the medial side on the heel section. Also on this lateral side, we're gonna have this Nike Shield logo. And as we go inside, guys, you can see that we have this black lining, which underneath it has actually a very good amount of padding. So this one for sure will keep your ankle section very tight in place. As in for the actual insole, guys, we're gonna have this foam insole, which is in this green color. We're also gonna have the Nike swoosh here. And of course, we're gonna have this very nice and interesting logos here at the heel section, which I guess it tries to explain us that this one will be good in all conditions. Also here at the back of the heel section, guys, we have this stripe, which also has some 3M reflective hints, so this one will be very easily seen during the night runs. And now, guys, we can go to this React midsole, which is completely the same as the normal Pegasus. This one is in this black color, and as you can see, it has a lot of splatters of this 3M reflective paint again. We also gonna have written here on the side the Air Zoom. So this is completely the same as the normal Pegasus. But now we're gonna get to this rubber outsole, which is called the Storm Tread. So this pattern, it's actually using some rubber as in the winter tires. So this one most definitely will be very grippy during the wet runs. And as you can see, we're gonna have this Storm Tread logo here in this pink color. As in for the actual sizing, guys, for this one I went with my true to size, and I can tell you that this one is actually quite good on my foot. But I will advise you that if you have a wider feet than normal, you should go with a half size up, and that will be mainly because this heel section here is not gonna be so wide, so most definitely that will be an inconvenience for you. Overall, guys, this new Pegasus shield, it's actually an improved version of the normal Pegasus, of course, which uses the same midsole, which is actually a good thing, because that one is very comfortable and it gives a very good response. But of course, this upper will be completely changed. We're gonna have this material, which as you can see now, it doesn't let any water through. So to be honest, I'm not entirely sure how this will react during the long runs. But if you manage to experience this shoe already during the long runs and you had some water coming in, please do let me know in the comment section down below. But rather than that, guys, I really like how this shoe it's covered in a lot of rubberized material. But you need to keep in mind that just because of this rubberized material used throughout, this one will be a bit stiffer than your usual Pegasus. So yeah, guys, I really hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to press the like button, maybe also subscribe to the channel. You can also leave some comments in the comment section down below. And as always, I will see you in my next one. Thanks for watching.